Some movies are so good, you've got to watch them more than once. What's up, Doc? Caddyshack. It's a mad, 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 mad world. All classics that I love. Camelot, Wizard of Oz, you know, I thought it was just entertaining, but now I know it's about the gold standard. There's always these hidden messages, but early on it was more musicals. I watch a lot of Japanese movies. There's a brilliant one called Nowhere in Africa that you get a glimpse of Africa, out of Africa, another incredibly beautiful, brilliant movie. You know, it's so eclectic. There's documentaries like Battle of Algiers or Gatekeepers. There's an old one called Z about the Greek military. You know, they were so fascinating, so well made. Movies about tough conditions in poor countries don't do that well. Jeff Skoll's been able to take some causes like the danger of a big epidemic. And do things like Contagion that really, you know, hopefully reminded people that we are at risk. I probably watched Spy Game more than any other movies, maybe 8 times. Sound of Music with Melinda quite a bit. Great Gatsby, 3 Days of the Condor. You know, things like Black Mirror are very provocative. The movie Her, you know, that's definitely coming. They did a very clever job with that. I think this idea of a social score, where everything you do, you know, people get to rate you highly or lowly, and you can get on a bad trend with that, that was very clever. There's another one where you can play back exactly what happened to you, and that, they really show how strange that would be. I read a lot of science fiction when I was young, and so all the stuff about robots, Terminator, AI, you know, looking at super intelligence and how that would come along. You know, it's great that we can imagine bad things, and hopefully it helps us try to avoid them.
Can I just-